Hello students, today in this video of ours we are going to learn about the different phylums of animal kingdom. Like now that we are familiar with all the terminology, what is diploblastic, triploblastic, acoelomate, pseudocoelomate, true coelomate, then segmentation of the body, viviparous, oviparous, warm-blooded, cold-blooded. These are the all terms which we have learned. And all these terms, after learning all these terms, now we are ready to see how the different animals are classified into different phylums as per their characteristics. Term, basically, first of all, they are divided into two major classes, that are chordates and non-chordates. The major difference between these two is that the chordates are having notochord and non-chordates are not having notochord. Now, what is notochord? Notochord is a mesodermally formed, that means it is formed of mesoderm, and it is a rod-like structure which is made up of tightly packed vacuolated cells which run along the mid-dorsal line. Like this is our dorsal side and this is our ventral side. So mid-dorsal line, you will find that it runs there. The notochord is running. And if the notochord is present, the organ is called chordate. And if notochord is absent, it is called non-chordate or non-chordate animal. So animals showing a vertebral column, and if you move advanced, then what will happen? There is a vertebral column and these animals are called vertebrates. And if the vertebral column is not present, they are called invertebrates. So first of all, we will do what are non-chordates, because we have to go from simple to complex. So first we will do non-chordates. Notochord is absent here. So all non-chordates we will do first. And in that, the first phylum that comes is the porifera. Now, pori means pores, bearing. So pori means pores. So these organisms, they are having pores all over their body. That's why they are called porifera. And commonly all sponge you must have seen, all sponges come in this phylum. Porifera. This is the simplest pore-bearing organisms, maybe solitary, colonial, or sedentary. Solitary means alone, the one organism alone. And colonial means many organisms together in a colony, because they are living in a colony. And when they are living alone, that is called solitary. And sedentary means they are not moving. They are present at one place. That is called sedentary. Mostly marine. They are mostly present in the seawater. Some are freshwater as well. Vase-shaped or cylindrical body. Flower vase you must have seen. This is the shape of the flower vase. So their body is, the body of the poriferians is vase-shaped or cylindrical body. Body shows cell aggregate plan. That means the tissues are not yet being formed. The cellular level of organization is present in the body. Body is made up of cells only. Tissues are not present. No organs, no organ system. Only the cells, group of cells are present in the body. So we can say that organization level is cellular. Then ostia are small pores through which enters the body. Ostia are the small pores which are present all over the body, and through these pores the water enter into the body. And then there is one opening which is called osculum, and through this osculum the water comes out of the body. And there is a coelom, there is a cavity in between which is called osteocoel. So ostia are present, small pores, and through which the water enters. Then there is an osculum through which the water comes out, and then there is a cavity. So what this canal is doing, this is doing the function of digestion, excretion, respiration. Because the food from the water comes into the body through these ostias, and then in the body the food get digested, and then the excretory material comes out of the body through the osculum with the help of water only. Similarly, the oxygen also comes in through ostia and it leaves through osculum. Similarly, the excretory materials also, they leave the body through osculum. So this is the specialty of porifera. They are having a body cavity which is called spongocele. So ostia are present, osculum is present, and spongocele is present. Now choanocytes help in digestion, because here the digestive system is absent. There is no peculiar digestive system. The choanocytes are the cells which are helping in the digestion. Exoskeleton is made up of cilia. The exoskeleton is present. That means the outside the body, the silica is present, which is helping in supporting the body. So this exoskeleton is made up of silica, calcium carbonate, or protein spongin fibers. So they are there. These chemicals are there outside the body to help the body getting support. Porifera feed on detritus. What is detritus? The dead and decaying material which is present in the water. Asexual reproduction is taking place by budding, and sexual reproduction is taking place by gametes. So gametes are also formed, and here the body is hermaphrodite. Hermaphrodite means the body is capable of producing both the gametes, male as well as female. Male gamete as well as female gamete is produced by a single body, and that organism is called hermaphrodite. And sponges have great power of regeneration. What is regeneration? You break the sponge into many fragments, and each fragment can give rise to a new sponge. So that is the power of regeneration which is present with the porifera. Now if you see the example, the zygon is there, the eusporangia is there. These are the ostias. These are the ostias. So you will find ostia all over the body, and then osculum is one, that is exit for the exit of the water, and then there is spongocele. See this. This is osculum. So osculum is one, which from where the water exits. Now the water is flowing inside through these pores, which are called ostia. And this is the spongocele, the cavity. And these are the choanocytes. These choanocytes are helping in the digestion. These are present inside this spongule. And there are spicules also. This is one choanocyte. So food particles are entering in this, and there is phagocytosis of food particle. Phagocytosis means it engulfs the food, and then it gets digested with the help of the enzymes.